Rian.
Pa.
I'm glad you were able to come. Let's just wait a while for Franco. I guess he's running late today. Let's discuss our plan involving Pascal the minute he arrives. We have to decide what to do with him. Do you want to drink or eat anything?
I need to head back to camp right away. They might look for me.
Ah, I understand. But stay first. Sit down. Let's catch up. Or, better yet, tell me, what is up with you? I mean, how is life inside the camp? And your mission involving the Leons?
Well, they're suffering.
Did I hear it right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they're suffering. Wow. That's fantastic news. Wait. So what happened? Why are they suffering? What trick did you pull? What did you do to make the enemy suffer?
I didn't do anything, Pa. But I think it's you who did something.
I'll let you know when you can speak to my wife. Let's help each other out. Thank you so much.
Are you leaving soon? Can you wait for me? I'll just change.
Wait. Hold on. I think it would be better if you stayed home and rest.
But I have to go to Arabella. I need to fix a lot of things there, so we can resume operations, and I feel better now, and I won't feel at ease staying at home. The restaurant badly needs me now. I'm fine, and I promise to have myself checked just in case. You don't need to worry about me. I overheard your conversation with the police. They want to talk?
They just want to know what happened that night. Don't worry. The usual follow-up investigation.
Some men broke into the restaurant that night. If I'm not mistaken, there were three of them.
Are you sure you only saw three?
Well, I wasn't able to get a good look because Rian and I hid right away, and things got blurry and confusing.
You were with Rian?
Yes.
The whole time?
Yes, but she...
But what?
Well, she left me there for a while to get help.
How long was she gone?
I'm really not sure. I'm sorry, but everything happened so fast. The next thing I knew, you were already there to save us. Wait for me, okay?
Sure.
I'll just get changed.
Take your time.
Pa, I heard their daughter died. Because of your attempt to get revenge?
That liar! How dare he say that? They were furious with me, that's why they made me the prime suspect. And even if they didn't have a single piece of evidence against me, they still blamed everything on me alone. Because they wanted to ruin my reputation. I didn't kill their child, okay? The truth is, they were the one who killed my son. They killed your brother! The one person who saved your life. That's why you must do everything to avenge his death. They're trying to make me look like the bad guy here. You think I am a criminal?
I just wanted to hear the truth from you, Pa.
That guy's so annoying. So full of himself.
Give me my phone. We're even now.
Hey, wait! I said wait! Why is my phone screen all broken? I returned yours in perfect condition. Well, you'll have to pay for this. Look at what you did, look at it!
Miss, I won't pay. I didn't break your stupid phone. I swear, it wasn't me.
Oh, then what is this? It looked perfectly fine the last time I had it. And now you're returning it in this condition? You're paying for this.
No way. Why should I?
Ah, why you ask? There. Because if you don't, that face of yours will go viral. Just so you know, this phone is my means of living, so it's important to me. How am I supposed to contact my customers now?
Miss,
so come on, pay up.
Will you stop it? You're wasting my time here.
Oh, so you won't pay for it. Please? Help
me! Wait, stop!
Help
me! Miss, I told you I didn't break it, and I got nothing to pay you with.
You can pay me in other ways.
Hold on. Really, miss? Oh, man. Why are you looking at me like that? Okay, look. I know I'm a cute guy, but I won't use my body to pay for your phone. I still have dignity.
Don't be stupid. Do you honestly think I have no taste? I'm not interested in your body.
What then?
I want your bike.
Come on.
That's yours, right? Unless you stole it from someone else, too.
That bike is mine, and I have proof.
Then use that to pay me.
That's not gonna happen, miss. My bike is more expensive than your lame phone.
I'm not taking your bike, dumbass. What I meant was you're going to be my driver every time I go to the market. That's the deal. I'll avoid traffic and save some money to buy myself a new phone. So, you see? Now you can say we're even.
You're crazy, miss.
Oh, I'm crazy, huh? What are you saying? Fine. Okay. Look over here. Hey, don't leave now. Look at the camera.
Stop
Come on.
It.
There. I'll post this on social media. Your stupid face will go viral in seconds. Well, would you like that? Don't worry. I keep my end of the bargain. I'm Claire. And you? What's your name?
Ivan.
Don't forget my helmet.
What are you looking at? You have a crush on me?
But you got to believe when I tell you.
Franco, General. Any update from Aurora?
We're all good there, General. I personally checked where Pascal will be dropped off. I'm sure that no one will be there, especially the military.
Very good.
And I also told our men to stay alert, sir, so that the military won't know about this.
We have to carefully execute this, Rian. We need to make sure that our enemies won't know about this plan of ours. And if they ever do find out, if you think there's cause for us to be concerned, you have to inform us immediately. Dear, I'm gonna need an answer. What will it be?
Yes, Pa.
Okay. Good.
Sir, we've confirmed that Pascal is in Taiwan, jumping from island to island.
Inform intel. I need to know the exact location and the exact island where Pascal is, and put Special Force Aguila on standby.
Yes, sir.
And wait for my command.
Yes, General. Consider it done.
Dismissed.
Sir.
Listen. I need the support of the Navy on this.
I'll handle that.
Amelia? Lucy! Luciana Galantis. General Galantis' wife.
Oh, Lucy! Sorry, I didn't recognize you.
How are you?
Please join me. I'm really sorry I didn't recognize you. I thought you were in America.
Well, we are all back. You see, we would much rather retire here than in America.
Good for you. Is the general with you?
Oh, no. He's back at the camp. He's currently meeting with some of his batchmates. They're asking if we want to try sponsoring this fundraising event for General De Leon's. Marshall, remember him?
Oh, yes. How could I forget Marshall?
By the way, the fundraising event. Are we still doing that like last year?
Yes. We need to do it. We're the ones who started it. That's our way of showing our deep gratitude to all the soldiers for their commitment and unyielding support.
Well, I just figured, Marshall, that with all that has happened in the past couple of weeks, maybe we could postpone it. Our men will understand.
The proceeds will fund the education of our soldiers' kids. They're counting on us. We can't disappoint them. We do this for them every year.
Aren't you going to the event? I think you should, because I heard a lot of people will be attending the fundraising event. Everyone from your batch will be there. You know, we're all so excited since it's our first time to attend.
So Marshall spearheads this kind of event.
Why? Don't tell me you haven't been to one.
Oh, well, Chago and I have been busy.
You have to make time. Give me your number. I will send you the details and I will send you the invitation.
Lieutenant, you can speak with him now.
Thank you, sir.
Right this way.
Ma'am, what else do you need to know? The people responsible were already caught, right? I just want to confirm something.
What do you want?
I'm the only daughter of the owner of the restaurant you broke into. I just want to ask you something.
What is it?
The night you broke into the restaurant, you had companions and they got beat up, right? Aside from my father, who else did you encounter?
After the lights were turned off, I couldn't see anything. Suddenly, someone attacked me. When I regained consciousness, the cops were already there.
You don't remember what happened? You don't remember who attacked you? How he looked like? Was he a tall guy? Was it a man or a...
I can't remember. It all happened in a blur. I even lost count of all the punches. He moved too fast. He's as swift as the wind.
Ma'am? That night, Rian was the only person my mom was with. Could Rian possibly be the person they encountered?
But how could she do that?
Exactly! As a military nurse, the training that she underwent should not have been enough for her to fight those three men in the dark.
But if Rian really saved your mom, shouldn't you be happy about it?
It's been bothering me. I'm just curious why she had to hide the fact that she helped mom.
Maybe she doesn't want the attention?
Or maybe there's something else. Maybe she's hiding something from us. It could be about someone. Maybe her real identity.
All right, miss, I'll get that later. I'll just get something over there. All right, see you. Thank you.
Thanks.
It's really cheap.
Hi there, how much do I have to pay for everything?
Oh, yes.
Give me a huge discount, okay? I bought a lot of clothes from you.
Of course, you're my loyal customer.
Thanks a lot.
How much longer are we doing this?
Oh, let me get that.
We're almost done. Will you please stop pouting and just wait? That's bad luck.
I really hope you get bad luck.
What did you say?
Nothing. Did you hear anything?
I heard you mumbling.
I wasn't.
Next time, say it louder so I can hear you. What's your problem? You want to go home now? Then go! I won't stop you, but I will post your picture on social media to make your face go viral.
Hey, my phone's ringing. Give me my phone.
Here.
I just need to take this.
Wait, hold it. Don't you dare try to escape.
Lord, I just need to take this call.
All right. Hey, stop right there. Don't move. Stay right there.
Go there. It's too noisy here.
Hello, bro. What's wrong with you, Ivan? I've been calling you since last night. What happened?
I'm really sorry, Franco. I was busy that night tailing that soldier.
Are you sure about that? Then how come a girl answered your phone last night?
What? A girl? Oh, that was nothing. Some crazy girl just pranked me. It's a good thing I got my phone back.
If I find out you're just fooling around with some chick, Ivan, I swear I will make you suffer.
Relax, man. I'm doing my job. Believe me.
Do your job well. Don't waste this opportunity for us to get back at our enemies.
I won't.
Hey, driver! Come on, help me with these! Hurry, it's so heavy! Oh. Thank you, Mr. Driver. Let's go, let's go!
Do you live here? At a tricycle terminal?
Of course not. I'll just ride the tricycle to get to our house.
Let me drive you home.
No way! What if you stalk me? You haven't earned my trust yet.
Suit yourself.
Anyway, bye.
Wait, stop. Give me back my helmet.
Oh, I'll do it myself. Hold on. Sorry.
Bye.
Wait. Before you forget, let me remind you about our deal. You will drive me around town until I get a new phone. You better keep your word or else I'll make you famous. Your face will be all over the city.
I'll find a way to pay you immediately so I won't have to see you again.
Don't tell me you're going to be a criminal.
None of your business.
Wait, stop, stop, stop,
what?
Stop.
What?
Here. Change your shirt before you go. You're already drenched in sweat. Hey, don't get any ideas. That vendor gave me that for free because I bought a lot from her. And you can have it since it won't fit my brother. So keep it.
Thank you.
See you tomorrow at 5 a.m. I'm delivering these.
Okay.
Claire.
Ethan.
You didn't tell me you were here. Let me help you.
Thank you.
Come on. Rian, what's going on with you?
Do you really care?
I'm just not used to seeing you like this. You seem so unenergetic, like you haven't eaten anything all day.
That's good news for you. This is your chance to show my father what you're made of.
You may be right. But I prefer being challenged. I long for the thrill. I like the old you, the feisty Rian, better. That would be more exciting. So my victories would taste so much sweeter.
Is that all I am to you? A rival? Someone to beat?
What's the matter? Aren't you used to it yet?
Well, we are on the same team. On the same side. We've been doing this since we were children. We grew up together in this kind of world. I want to treat you as a friend, Franco. It's just sad. You only see me as one thing. Your competition.
Remember General Galliantes?
Galliantes? Yeah. We were batchmates before. Why?
Well, earlier I learned from his wife, Lucy, that our friend Marshall has been hosting a fundraising event, which he does every year. And all the soldiers, both old and new, are invited. But you and I, not once did he invite us to that event. What, is he doing that on purpose? Does he really consider us as nothing but his sworn enemies? Is that it? That's why I figured I'm going to go to that event. What do you think? Hello, hello? Chago, are you even listening to me?
I'm not deaf. You've decided. You want to attend Marshall's fundraiser to piss him off.
What are you saying? I'm not going there alone. We need to go there together. Besides, that'll help their suspicions about us if we are there. What do you think? It's a good idea, right?
If you say so.
What is it? What is wrong? What's going on with you? You seem so troubled. What did you and your beloved daughter talk about anyway?
I found out today that Corazon told Rian about the time we ambushed them. About what we did to her daughter. Which means that until now, Corazon is still not convinced that her only daughter is dead.
Corazon! Corazon! Rian! That's all you ever think about!
Stop it, Amelia. Could you please set aside your jealousy just this once? Shut your mouth and listen to me. Rian's getting a bit suspicious because of the things Corazon's been saying to her. And no matter how hard I try to contain it by feeding her with lies, I can feel it. Rian has changed.
Chago! That's what I've been trying to tell you before. You just let Rian go near her real parents like it won't matter. Chago blood is thicker than water.
I know. But let me remind you, in case you forgot, I've never lost a single fight. Not once.
Gosh, I'm really excited for the fundraising event this Saturday. I'm telling you right now, on that night, I'll get myself a boyfriend.
That's all you ever think about.
Gosh, Milet, that event's for charity and not for you to have a boyfriend.
Yeah, she's right.
Whatever.
Oh, come on.
Rian. Rian. Oh, so are you ready for Saturday?
Saturday?
You know, the General's fundraising event. Don't tell me Ethan hasn't invited you yet.
Oh, that I remember, right.
You don't have a dress yet, right? Don't worry, I got you. I'll take you to that dress store near here. Their dresses are fabulous. You'll look glamorous in them. I'll help you with everything. Let's go? Hey!
All right, I'll leave everything to you. Could you also spruce me up?
Oh, you can count on that. You'll be the star of the night. Great.
What happened to her?
Our child was the biggest victim of Marshall and Chago's whole conflict.
Thank you. General.
Franco, while you are waiting for Pascal, I would like you to also keep an eye on Rian. You can even get more men if you like. Get twice or even thrice of what you have now. And not just Rian. Even the others. I want you to keep an eye on the people she interacts with inside the camp.
I see you also noticed a change in Rian.
About that, Franco. I want you to find out what could have caused the change we're seeing in her now.
Please put this over there. And this one too.
Rian!
Ma'am.
You're early. We're not ready yet. I'm still preparing for the cooking lessons.
Well, I figured you could use my help.
Oh, sure. Let's go to the kitchen. Come on.
Okay.
Hey, I feel sorry for Ma'am Corazon. It's bad enough her business is failing, and now there were robbers too.
What now? Should we start looking for a new job?
That's what I was thinking. But I feel bad for Mam Corazon.
I feel sorry for her too, but I'm more concerned about my family. I hope she finds a way to save their restaurant immediately.
I know.
How are you? Are you okay?
Of course I am, ma'am. What about you? Are you okay?
Oh, I'm doing really well. I just went for my checkup. He said that there's nothing to worry about as long as I take my medicine.
I'm really glad to hear that, ma'am.
Are you sure you're okay? I have no idea what you're going through, Rian. But I feel like you're carrying a very heavy burden. I won't force you to tell me what's wrong, but I just want you to know that I'm always here.
Thank you, ma'am.
Oh, finally. Here, try my pecan pie. I hope it makes you feel better.
I feel better now. It's delicious. Oh, wow.
Go ahead.
Mother, Rian and I are going to an event. That's tomorrow. It's Uncle Marshall's fundraising event. Thelma will take care of you while Claire's in school. She'll be back on time anyway. By the way, Aunt Corazon wants to say hi. She told me she'll visit you soon.
Yes, Mother. I can hear you. I can hear you, Mother.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Of course.
Hello? Rian? It's Mother. She woke up.
Really? what happened? Wait, what did you do? Have you called her doctor?
I did. Just now. He's on his way.
All right, I'll drop by too. I'm at Miss Corazon's restaurant though, but I'll see you there?
Sure.
Mother's fine now. She's responding sometimes. The doctor said we just need to keep her under observation.
Oh, I'm happy to hear that, Claire.
Thank you, Aunt.
Mother, I'm a captain now. Soon enough, I'll have the same rank as Father. And Claire, on the other hand, will be a nurse soon. She'll graduate in about 2 years' time, Mother. See, we're slowly fulfilling our promises to you, Mother. We never gave up on our promises. We never gave up on you either. We knew you'd get better. We believed you will. Mother, we were so happy when you woke up. I hope that you'll fully recover soon. So the three of us, you, me, and Claire, we can finally live the way we used to. Mother, always remember we love you so much.
She's going to be fine, Ethan. Don't worry.
Thank you so much, Sean.
Wow.
You really look stunning, my dear.
Of course, who else would I take after but my beautiful mother?
Wait, can you hold this for me?
Ma.
Here.
You don't have to.
You should wear it. I want you to look perfect, because that is what you are to me. There, it looks better on you.
Thank you, Ma. I hope I'm still the perfect daughter for you and Papa.
Of course you are. I don't think I could have ever survived anything without you. You made us so happy and you brought light back into our lives, Jessie.
I'm glad because that's all I want in life, for you and Papa to be happy. I would do anything just so I can say I deserve both your love and Papa's too. I love you, Ma.
I love you more.
Ready?
Yes.
You look dashing.
Thank you, Pa.
And sharp. Let's go.
Of all days, really?
Millet.
Oh, sir. Sir. Wow. Look at you. You look even more handsome today.
Thank you. How are you?
Me? Of course I'm pretty. But there's one problem. And it's bad timing. My stomach is upset. I don't want to make a mess, so I decided to just stay here today.
All right, just stay here. And it's better to drink medicine before it gets even worse.
I already did, sir. I actually drank a lot. Have a great time.
I will. I hope you get well soon.
It's a shame I can't go.
Oh, you're here. Hey, are you feeling better?
No.
Not yet?
Nope.
Wow. Shall we go now? What is it?
Did you see my girlfriend?
What?
Don't tell anyone. My girlfriend might get angry if she finds out that you're my date for today.
Don't worry, I won't tell anyone.
Happy you're here.
You're absolutely.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, hello, Lucy. How are you?
Good.
Let's
hello.
Go. They're here. Sir? Ethan.
Good evening.
Ethan.
Good to
Hi,
see
good
you,
evening,
Leah.
Sir.
Wow.
Leon. You look so lovely.
Thank you, ma'am. You too. You look amazing.
Thank you so much.
Hello. Nice to be here. Oh, good evening.
Good evening.
Hi.
What's he doing here?
Hi.
Hello.
Good evening. It's so nice to be here.
Good evening.
You don't know?
Oh.
Lucy.
Hello. We see each other again. Remember when we met before? You look good. Oh, excuse me. Marshal, it's so nice to see you again. Corazon.
General? Corazon, how have you been?
Mm.
What a wonderful event.
I'm just curious. Who invited you?
Oh, Lucy. You invited us, right?
Lucy was kind enough.
Yes.
Don't worry, Marshall. We didn't gate crash. oh my, what a nice setup. Wow. I absolutely had no idea you hold a fundraising event every year. So how come you never invited us, not even once? We used to be so close back in the day.
You know, you should always invite us to your fundraising events. Especially since we have the funds. And we're willing to donate.
Yes.
We want to help too.
Not to be rude, but, this is an exclusive, active officers-only event.
Oh.
Oh, my. I'm so sorry, we weren't informed about that. We don't mean to be rude. You see, we were only told, when we're invited, that, it would be an interesting, fun-filled event, so... We came here, we wanted to see, we're here for the entertainment. Marshall, don't worry. We'll behave ourselves.
Excuse me.
Okay.
Isn't this such a beautiful event?
Yes.
Officers. Ladies, I would like to offer a toast and our congratulations to none other than General Marshall de Leon for a very successful fundraising event. Cheers! Hear, hear. I think we've gathered more money for our soldiers this year than last year, huh?
I think so too. And I'm hoping that this year we'll receive more donations from you. Please don't be shy about it, because the more you give... the more children we can sponsor and help in their schooling.
To the Cavaliers! Cheers! 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 Yes! Excuse me. Everyone, please pardon me if I'm interrupting. Please stay here. Over here. My dear friends. General De Leon's project is really remarkable. He deserves another round of applause. What a great project. Marshall, Amelia and I donated a huge amount for this cause. And hopefully it would be put to good use, especially since it's for the children and their education. And, well, of course, I pray the funds won't end up in someone else's pockets. There are so many opportunists nowadays, am I right? Hmm?
Don't worry, Chago. Everyone here is aware that we hold this event every year, and we have an open book policy. All the funds that we've raised, down to the last centavo, will go straight to the soldiers' children.
Let's give General De Leon another round of applause. Oh, sure. Yeah.
Would you come with me?
Oh, yeah, sure. Marshall. Please. Before you say anything, I think I know what it is. I hope you won't give any malice to whatever happened in the ballroom earlier. I simply want to help. So please, don't make a huge fuss out of it.
Chago, all warfare is based on deception. That's one important lesson that I learned from you, especially... as a soldier.
Thank you.
I can see right through your words and actions. You can't fool me. So don't even try.
Hello again.
Oh.
First Lieutenant Amelia Montemayor Guerrero reporting for duty, sir.
General. The soldier is waiting for an acknowledgement from a high-ranking officer.
Thank you. I still remember everything about being a soldier. After all, once a soldier, always a soldier. But unfortunately, I was accused of all kinds of dirty lies.
I don't want to be rude, but if you can't respect this event we've prepared, as well as the officials who wish to help, you may leave. The exit door is right there.
Is this how you treat your guests? How disappointing. I mean, especially us, whom once in your life, and don't deny this, served in the military with you. You see, it doesn't seem nice. Especially since we're around highly respected officials of the army.
Yes. I once looked up to you as my officer. But you were dishonorably discharged years ago because of the things you did. And now, you are nothing but ordinary citizens.
Empty words, General. Empty words.
You might be good at hiding, or even better at running. It's a small world for soldiers like us. And you know that. And the day will come when you will make a mistake. And you best believe that when that happens, I will be there. I'll see you then.
See you, General. So sad.